Hi, I'm Dave Brown, and I've brought you to Chebsy Isaac Walton, where I recently broke the silverfish record with a weight of 43 lbs and 1 oz of roach, skimmers and bream, and a bonus perch. There's lots of roach in here of all sizes. There's some good quality roach to be caught on casters. There's lots of skimmer bream between 2 and 2 oz in a pound, and there's also bream up to 5 lb. I've not seen a bream of 5 lb, but I had a few of 3 lb on the day. But it's predominantly roach and skimmers. There's the odd perch. There are some big perch in here. I had one 2 lb, 2 lb plus on the day. But I've heard of some 3.5 to 4 lbs being caught. Right, so I've fished two lines, one at about 7 m, which will be mostly with casters, feeding the ball of ground bait, and then at 14.5 m, I'll be fishing a couple of balls of ground bait, possibly one of those will be loose. With chop worms, casters and a few maggots in, and I'll be looking to catch on top of that ground bait and past it. The reason I'm fishing so long is because it is the middle of January, it is cold, the water is clear, you get depth out there, and I believe the skimmers are more comfortable in that kind of depth of water. Although you will catch some short, you won't catch a weight of them short, you need to go to them more than they'll come to you. I'll feed the lines differently because I'll be looking to catch more roach on the short line, and I'll be using less ground bait there and perhaps feeding more casters. Whereas on the longer line, if I can get them skimmers going, I'll be giving them a ball of ground bait every other fish, just a little nugget through a cad pot, and then I'll be loose feeding casters over the top. The long pole line is fed with ground bait, and it is a mixture of F1 dark with a little fish meal greening. I believe skimmers like fish meal, so I'm giving them that little bit of flavour. I'm not putting too much in, just putting a little bit of flavour in, and I'll give them two balls of that, obviously with some offerings of loose feed as well. On top of the two balls I put in, I've put a loose cup of ground bait with the same ground bait but just not squeezed into a ball, and that is just to give the peg like a kind of kickstart, gives it a bit of attraction going down through the peg. So I'll hopefully draw some fish into it. So the short line, I tend to start just feeding casters at the start and feel my way into the peg. I noticed the chap to my right on the match, he fed ground bait from the start and caught tiny little roach. Whereas me just loose feeding casters, I caught a much better stamp of fish. But eventually it did slow down. So I thought maybe it's time to give him a ball of ground bait. And I gave him just a little nugget of the same mix with nothing in it, and just loose fed casters over the top, and it did bring the peg back to life. But I didn't want to do it from the start in case I brought too many small fish in. I fed it at 14.5 m, but I believe skimmers and bream will always sit, not always, but they will tend to sit off the back of the feed. So fishing with a 16 m section, I'm feeding with a 14.5 and then shipping past it at times to fish at 16 m, and you'll get them bonus fish off the back of your feed. And obviously if you lose feeding with a catapult anyway, some of your offerings will go past your feed anyway, so you are feeding that line as well. So you will pick up those odd better fish off the back of your feed. Right, so it's a simple bait tray. I've got casters, maggots, a few fluoro pinkies, and a few thin perfect micro pellets. Most of these will be added to the ground bait at the start. The pinkies won't be used so much unless the fishing's hard. And then I'll loose feed casters over the top of the ground bait mixes. So it's a nice simple bait table really. Right, for the short line, I've set up a 4x16. There's a bit of wind on this today, and I need heavier rigs. So I've put a set up of 4x16 F1 Maggot with a strung out shotting pattern. That might get changed to a double bulk pattern if I do catch some skimmers there. But on the long line, like I said, it is windy. There's a bit of a tow on it. So I've set up a 0.75 Preston power float. And that's got a bulk of number 8 stots with a couple of number 8 stot droppers. Both rigs have got a 0.9 AccuPower hook length and a size 16 SFLB. And I'm using single slip 6 elastics on both rigs today. Early on in the match, patience is a big part of it. You're not always going to catch straight away. It is winter, it is clear, it is cold. So you've got to be prepared to wait. I mean, you can wait for up to 2 hours for an arrival of fish. So patience. If it's getting desperate and I'm not getting any bites, I will try feeding some pinkies, because that can sometimes spark them into life. I probably wouldn't give them any more ground bait, because there's obviously been nothing there to feed off it anyway. So to try and spark something to happen, I'll be loose feeding casters anyway, but I may back off that and try feeding pinkies just to get a bite, and then work from there. Once you've got some fish in your peg, you can work from there. Once you've got the fish feeding in your peg, obviously if you've started feeding pinkies and you've made something happen, I'll continue to do that unless I get a proper arrival of fish, then I can up it to either maggots or casters. If the skimmers do arrive on that long line, say, I won't be scared to keep giving them a little nugget of ground bait every couple of fish just to keep them happy. But you feel your way into it as you're going. Sometimes it's better with loose feed. Sometimes it's better to give them a bit more ground bait. On the short line, I probably wouldn't give them another ball until I stop catching there. I'll just continue loose feeding over the top. So having a cad pot on the tips on the silvers match is an advantage, because you can put a tidy pile of bait in around your float. Loose feeding is going to get the fish into your peg, hopefully. But then to concentrate them, I use a cad pot to get them around where my hook bait's going to be. Right, so I do a lot of canal fishing in the summer months, but not so much in the winter months. When it gets really hard fishing, there's no boats on the canals, fish shoal up tight, you've got to be a proper draw bag to get on some fish, so I tend to leave it alone. This kind of thing, silverfish fishing on commercials, it scratches that itch in winter, and it's great fishing at times. There's a lot of untapped fish to be caught at this time of year.